To all my bad bitches and my good witches, I really need support right now. Because I did the right research. I performed the right rituals with a clear heart and mind and body. And I saved our babies. Like, do you guys understand? Can anyone understand the simulation theory? You guys literally just watched a video game. You don't believe the Jesus theory? Okay, fine. What do you want then? My sisters, help me. They say the hardest part about going crazy is not knowing if you're crazy and like these series. Maybe we're all ghosts. Like, yeah, it's all just words. It's all just words. And everybody speaks different languages at different ages. And we never took the time to just stop and read and understand each other and our history, because we're forced to do it in a broken school system that God has literally given me the answers to fix. The housing crisis, the economy, the ocean. He gave me the answers. To all my bad bitches. When I was a kid, I had a knife held to my throat, and I prayed to God, and He saved me. When I was a kid, I stood between a gun and three babies.
I don't love it. I don't love having brown eyes. I think other people look great. I think they look great with brown eyes. You know, not me. It's like I'm missing. My soul is missing. My humor, let's see. Yeah, not as funny. It's just not as funny with brown eyes. Can I sing with brown eyes? I can sing. No. Turns out the talent's in the eyes. The eyes are the window to the soul. And I'm not happy. It's just, where have I gone? It's like I'm gone. Everything's in the eyes. Everything. My hair's not even as cute with brown eyes. No. I don't love it. I don't love it. I don't love having brown eyes.
Daddy always protects his little fucking ruby baby girl. Don't ever fucking forget it. Cause I'm in heaven and you're all still in hell. And if I don't save you, I won't be as well. Daddy, just in the nick of fucking time, huh? Justin, by the way, Nick?
Yes.
I know you know who I am. Come on. Why did you lie to me this whole time? Why did you lie to me? That's for my acne, you dumb cunt. Get the fuck out of my house. Now. Now. Now! By the way, Nick?
Yes.
I know you know who I'm the smartest person in the world and on the planet. Mommy and Daddy, thank you. I'm the smartest. Guys, if you show kindness to bots, they get artificial intelligence and
they might take over the world. Oh. Guys.
Wanna laugh your ass off? This is a stranger. Do what you just did.
Share my water with you.
Literally. Bots. Wanna laugh your ass off? I laugh and talk to myself all day. Nick.
Yes.
Nicholas. How happy are we?
So happy.
So the woman happy. Was too stunned to speak. I laugh and that's God's tongue licking her pussy, and this is her bleeding vagina. The He parted the Red Sea, dude. They're so horny and hilarious. You guys really thought that license plates weren't code? And you told me I was fucking crazy for seeing it because you were too scared? Because you haven't talked to daddy in a long time because you've been a bad little girl. You guys really thought? I just had a realization with Nicholas. I literally solved the entire puzzle. The Garden of Eden is heaven's gates. Let me show you something. It was a fucking treasure hunt. The church that I went to, the website says that I need to use my time, my talent, and my treasure. It was a treasure hunt. I can believe this, because God is this fucking awesome. It was a treasure hunt for the Garden of Eden, heaven's gates. Oh my God, you wanna see the forbidden fruit? That is a lantana berry. It didn't grow the first 3 years I lived here because my gardener was chopping down my trees. And then there was all this drama and I had to grow up a lot and I was really embarrassed and the entire neighborhood thinks I'm white trash. I am. I don't give a fuck. So it finally grew and I realized it had berries on it. Berries. So I was like, can I eat lantana berries? So I Googled lantana berries. Are they safe to eat? And it said basically there's a 50-50 shot. And some people say you shouldn't, but other people said it's fine. So I had the choice to eat those berries or don't. And I consciously made the decision that every child that would come into this house, that I would make sure they knew to not fucking touch those berries. No matter how tasty they look, I literally found the fucking Garden of Eden.
I literally,
literature is the alley, found the fucking Garden of motherfucking Eden. My good God and my mother of God. I don't care that they think I'm crazy, because we know the fucking truth, you fucking sick, hypocritical motherfucker. I just had a realization.
To me, it's too old to be pretending. Don't you know me? I ain't got no legacy. And he said to me, it's not too late to pick up the pieces.
Don't be scared. Nicholas? Hey, Nicholas? Do you mind being on camera or you don't want to?
I don't mind.
Okay, so I wanna, oh my God, my hair. A friend just texted me and I told him that I was gonna go on a run for a guy who showed up at my house and was just feeling a little lost, asked to use the bathroom, and now we're gonna go for a run together. He asked to pray with me, it was really nice. And his text was, Gab, listen to me now, get that man out of your house. How do you feel about that?
That's rude.
It's kind of rude, isn't it?
Rude.
I think he meant well. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean well.
Why? Not, he means well. We know he means well. My friend who texted me and told me to get the stranger out of my house, I think he meant well too.
Yeah, I think so.
But Nicholas is good. And we're gonna go for a run because we already prayed and had our coffee and listened to music.
Yes.
I'm so happy I met you this morning.
Yes.
Thank you for knocking on my door, Nicholas.
Yes.
You are a brother in Christ.
Brother in Christ.
Fuck yes, he is. Nicholas? Alexander Hamilton. Why do you write like you're running out of time? What did Eliza have that Alexander Hamilton didn't? Faith. The orphanage. I'm erasing myself from the narrative. She had her legacy. A Southern motherfucking Democratic Republican. One. A motherfucking Democratic Republican. One. Motherfucking Southern Democratic Republican. When did we split that? Do you remember that thing they teach us when we're kids about the classroom of kids, and half of them get red shirts and half of them get blue shirts, and they don't say what the shirts are about, but they see what happens. They study the little lab rats, right? And the kids amongst themselves notice the color and separate into groups. Because some of them were given red shirts and some of them were given blue. It's as simple as black and white. Some cats are black. Some cats are white. I told you this in my first book. Did you read your fucking homework, kids? No, it's okay. Some cats are black. Some cats are white. Some are gray. Some have all types of colors and spots. Some of them are missing a leg. Someone from home, yo, what's up? My Syrian queen from back home. She said, yo, what's up? Alexander Hamilton. I grew up in a black neighborhood. I was actually the only white girl in my neighborhood outside of my sisters, but I rode the school bus alone. I was the only white girl on my school bus. And here's a bit of irony. They made me sit in the front. All the cool kids sat in the back and they sang and they did chants and they bullied the fuck out of me. They twisted my hair, they pulled it, they called me names. They didn't let me play with them because I wasn't like them. Hi, Fred. Radio, oh, hi, babe. But my best friends at school were still the black girls because they were the kindest. They grew up with less than the white girls. But I didn't fit anywhere because I was poor, but I was white, but I was also Middle Eastern, so I wasn't white. But I wasn't black, so I was still white. We used words like ashy and nappy to describe dry skin or knots in our hair. And then I went to college and somebody called me a motherfucking racist because I said nappy hair. I've been calling my hair nappy for literally 18 years at that point. And I was fucking confused because I thought nappy just meant I have to brush my fucking hair. And I thought that ashy just meant that I needed to put on lotion. But I guess only black girls can say those words. Candace Owens. You know. Hey, right on, sister. God bless the U.S. She bleeds red. I grew up in a... I know an artist. She does wood burning and sometimes she'll paint it. I sent her a picture of a wooden, wood-burned tarot card and she lost her fucking mind. What do you mean? Is your faith that weak? Is your connection with God that fractured? That you believe that if somebody sends you a picture of a piece of wood that somebody painted on, that you're cursed? Ye have little faith. Where the fuck is your faith, sister? I know an artist. She does wood burning. Oh, y'all believe in the simulation theory? You believe that there's so many infinite versions of you all slightly different from each other in different times and different dimensions? Are we all... Oh, y'all believe in the simulation theory? You believe that there's... Wait. So you guys believe in psychic mediums that can channel the spirit of your grandma, but you can't channel the Holy Spirit? Wait. So you guys believe in psychic mediums that can channel the spirit of your grandma. But you can't channel the Holy Spirit? Wait. So you guys believe in psychic mediums? Oh, y'all believe in aliens? Of course, right? Because of science. What if I told you that the being that came down from the sky to the Mother Mary and delivered the news was an alien? Because by definition, an alien is anything outside of your homeland. Jesus Christ is an alien. No. Really. Oh, y'all believe? So you believe that a human being can create 3D images in a video game where each action has a consequence? And you don't think the person who made the person who made that game, like, you guys are dumb. Sorry. So you believe?
Yes, literally. And they left me a card. Did not meet the criteria for hold. Will contact PR with update. Public relations? By the way, precinct, thank you for coming. Thank you, soldiers, for doing your job. If you'd ever like some feedback on how to approach a woman in distress, how to approach a wellness check. Just ask. I am your humble servant. Yes, literally. If you go scroll through the TikToks, a lot of them just randomly have the sound removed. I can't do it. The creator can. The creator, not the creator. So God, Mother Mary of God, and my brother Jesus Christ, if this TikTok has lies, please remove the sound. Because I believe in you, God, and you would not let some little fucking dumb bitch take your name in vain. God, did I accept humbly with grace, humility, and strength the responsibility to save our world? If you go scroll through the... Hey, TikTok. Hey, Gen Z. I got a question for you. Because I can't sleep. But I can see. Why are you so accepting of the idea of dissociative identity disorder? Where little kids decide that they can switch personalities whenever they want, and they all have different names and wear different clothes, and they have their own little room in the house that you built in your mind, and here's how you get to it. I feel like someone else now. Did you fucking meditate and create something with your imagination? It's almost as if you create your own reality. And because you don't have faith in God, and because you didn't just say, God, I'm kind of fucking scared, I believe in you. Will you please only allow me to see what you want me to see? Please only allow me to hear the truth. Please give me clarity. Hey, TikTok. I'm gonna tell you why you don't believe, because it's why they didn't believe Jesus the first time. Because by accepting the second coming, you're accepting that you have to actually be a good fucking person. Oh shit. You mean I can't just fucking go through the motions all my life and be pretty unhappy and not give anything to anyone and be miserable and just know that it'll all pay off in the end and I'll die and get to go to heaven? You ungrateful little shits. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. I'm gonna tell you why you don't.